of his Florida Marlins teammates on hand participating in the ceremonial puck drop. The Panthers coming off their bye week and looking to extend their winning streak to four games. The Kings, meanwhile, have been shut out in two straight contests as they enter the finale of a four-game road trip. We go to the Sunshine State.
Austin Brown back to the point. The shot off the stick ends up in the corner. Ryder looks for somebody in front. And there they score! Deflected in, and the Kings get the opening goal of the game, and that's been a good thing all season long as Dustin Brown gets the power play goal.
Brown ran out of options, but this is a set play by Dustin Brown.
That one didn't go from almost the same angle as Dustin Brown scored from. Tanner Pearson puts it in the goal mouth, knocked away, the rebound, they score! Jeff Carter bangs home the loose puck, and it's 2-0 Los Angeles.
It was Pearson that kept it alive, and then he takes over. Look at the back and forth, puck protection. He's got a guy, Ekblad, draped all over his back. When it makes it to Carter, you kind of know what's going to happen there.
Playing it up, doesn't get it to the blue line, and out in safety, and with that, Carter is out of the penalty box. So no damage done until now, right at the tag end after the power play had expired. The Florida Panthers, Jussi Jokinen on the doorstep, has cut the margin in half.
4-on-4, they have not had that luxury much this season because of injury.
Huberdeau just got back into the lineup, first time this season last Friday against the Ducks, and scored the game winner, and the Los Angeles Kings have just taken a 3-1 lead as Tyler Toffoli on this 4-on-4 play rooted it up over the shoulder of Reimer. Pearson able to move it on down the right side from the LA Kings. In deep, and they score! It's a nice centering pass. I mentioned earlier from the back of the net out in front, and there's Pearson all alone. Nobody around him. It's 4-1 Los Angeles. Playing again in the forward end of the ice. Robbins Parkley at the blue line. McNabb. The two together into the goal mouth, and the one go down as
the Kings, it's in. The puck is in the net. It's going to be Lewis from behind, pass in front. There's a jam. Puck's in the net.
Oh, yeah.
Puck's in the net. We have a goal on the ice, yes. There's the overhead look. You see King gets his stick on it. The puck was never covered.
Here at the left point, Braden McNabb had it knocked away, but his teammates back him up. Given right back to McNabb. The left side and over the line is Pearson. Carter to the front of the net, he scores! Carter from Pearson, it is 6-1.
Attack and drive the net. Attack and drive the net. That's what the Kings have been doing all night long.
He's unable to move it up the left wing board, so they'll reverse it, but the Panthers on it quickly into the slot. Twice turned aside by Peter Budaj. Here's an opportunity, and Marchessault left all alone. Taken the possibility of a game-winning goal with the second one away from Jeff Carter. It's now 6-2. Bob Miller asked me to get some goals for his Kings tonight. We've accomplished that. We're going to have a victory on the board. And when they head back to L.A., it'll be 6-3 as a final in all likelihood. As that is banged by Peter Budaj with only 21.2 seconds left. Alexander Barkov, who's been quiet most of the night, was on the doorstep.
The Kings break out of their offensive woes in a big way, winning at 6-3, snapping the Panthers' three-game winning streak. LA finishes their road trip at 2-2. The Kings now 13-2 in their last 15 meetings against Florida. Up next, the Kings host the Coyotes after their bye week next Thursday, and the Panthers visit the Preds.